There are no guarantees in life, but there is a natural order. Parents should not survive their children.
But as we all know, that's often not the case. Tonight, I'd like to share Anna's story. It's about a little girl who was dying of cystic fibrosis. Anna and her family wanted to share the story to raise awareness and funds to find a cure. It's a simple tale of a little girl, any little 8-year-old girl who just loved life. This is Anna's story. This is Anna. Anna's dying. Her life may be coming to an end, but Anna's story is just beginning to be told.
Trisha came out so we could tell your story, okay? About CF and everything, about the fight and the battles, and we filled her in on all that, all right?
When I walk in there to see her, I feel like I can't break down for her. I have to make sure that I stay strong, because that's what she's done for me. She's never, ever given me a time where she's been weak at all, so I don't want to do that for her.
Anna's story's simple. It's about a little girl who has a big disease. She's 8. She loves her sisters, loves Christmas morning, loves camping, the color blue, and pork chops. She's a soccer player and was looking forward to the new season that starts Saturday.
Hi, pretty girl.
She's also fighting cystic fibrosis with medicine, therapies, surgeries, hospital visits, and a lot of prayer. Anna's been fighting so hard and winning her bout with CF since she was 3 months old, until this time, when CF decided this fight would be her last.
They say it's a very progressive disease. They're not joking. You know, you get one, you get a cold, you're going to fight for 21 days probably to get rid of that cold, whereas for a healthy person, 7 to 10 days. You know, I mean, you have a big battle ahead of you, and sometimes it's just, you can't win them all.
A week ago, doctors told Anna's parents she was not going to get better. For whatever reason, the medication, the therapy, isn't working anymore, that Anna was going to die.
They sent us home with the news of, you know, things just aren't working anymore. Take her home, love her, do what you can spend, you know, appreciate the time that you guys have together. And that's what we've done.
You got your mommy right here, don't you?
Yeah. I walk in there, look at her right now, and she's like, my heart just aches because I think, oh my gosh. And I was just asking her before you got here, you do know how much mommy loves you, right? She's, mm-hmm. I'm like, I just want to make sure. And then she puts her arms around me. And that is just what you want. That is honestly, you need that. I want to make sure that she knew and knows just how much she's loved. And then not only by me, you know, her sisters, they do the same thing. You know, we all just kind of go in there and make sure that, you know, she knows. She does, she knows.
It's equally as hard on the family as it is on the individual. I mean, they're trying to stay so strong for us so we don't have to feel the pain and stuff that they're feeling. But at the same time, I mean, it's such an incredible burden to bear for her, you know, in our situation. It's that, I mean, she tries to take all that from us.
Anna's breathing tubes flow from the living room to her little bedroom where she lays cuddled up in a constant state of sleepiness from the pain medicine, unable to breathe on her own. She lie there underneath the posters of her favorite band. Her dream was to one day meet them or go to a concert. Her dying wish came true in a phone call Friday night. The band didn't want their names made public because they didn't do it for publicity, but for a little girl whose story touched their hearts. Occasionally, Anna opens her eyes and talks in a whisper.
Jen looks at Emma with her eyes closed and says, you know, Emma, you're the one I've always looked up to. I mean, it was just all the things you want to hear.
Anna's mom and dad knew she might die of CF one day, but never thought it would happen while she was in the third grade. And her mom never imagined she'd be telling her 8-year-old it was okay to let go. Anna answered with, I don't want to die, Mommy. I'm not going anywhere.
I never, ever thought that we would be in this spot right now, ever. I just didn't. I don't know if I just didn't want to see it or what. I just never, ever dreamed that it would be Anna. Not Anna. Never.
Her mom and dad hold their sick little girl in shifts now, so she's never alone. They pray that when she goes peacefully. And even though this is Anna now, this is the Anna they will always hold in their hearts. The cute little blonde with big blue eyes who never complained, always smiled and taught everyone around her that you should literally never take one breath for granted.
The one thing that I remember most about Anna, or ever will, is her big blue eyes with a really big smile.
We are so fortunate to have all these pictures of her in the 8 years, all the memories we do have. So now we don't have to sit here and think, why didn't we do this? What if we did that? And we can just sit and look at these. And my hardest thing that makes me the most upset is thinking ahead, well, we're not going to have her in the picture. That's where I get upset. That's what bothers me.
I know if I can do this. Anna died last night. It was peaceful. You can find out more about Anna's army and their fight to find a cure for cystic fibrosis, as well as Anna's visitation, her funeral arrangements. There's a link on our website, fox19.com, and you can also find Anna's story. It's all there.